What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Welcome back to Money Gang Crypto. So last night I had a Twitter space where I was basically asking people, what's your 2024 predictions? What's going to happen in the general markets? What's going to be the Bitcoin top? When will BlackRock rug us? What will happen when the big institutions who come in and the big mean institutions destroy the chart price? We had some guests up, and shout out to them. Thanks for coming up to the stage. But we had some that had high anxiety. You could just tell just from the voice that there is a lot of anxiety. And so I asked the question, well, okay, so what is your plan? What is your thoughts longer term? Because everyone kind of zooms in on the small stretch of time that we have right now. The small stretch of time that we have now is basically going to be the bull market, which is in 24, 25, give or take. And there's a lot of anxiety coming into that because a lot of people missed out on the previous bull market cycle. There are a lot of people that don't want to miss out. There are a lot of people in crypto that have missed tops and have unfortunately rode it all down to the bottom. And I get that. So my question today is, what is the top call? What is the Bitcoin top? What kind of range do you need to be at least on high alert, okay? Because all of this is speculation, right? When I speak to you on a camera and when I put out a prediction, it's not always going to be perfect. I can get close, right? It's like shooting a arrow with a blindfold. The more information and the more practice that you have, the closer you get to the target. However, it's not always perfect. It's not always going to hit the bullseye. So let's talk about it. Let's get straight into it. And here is the post that I put up. So what's your Bitcoin top call, MGC? So the Bitcoin community will say 150K plus, mainly based on the fact that they believe, in their minds, they believe the narrative of $1 million Bitcoin. Well, the HEX community have been saying that the sentiment's probably going to be 70 to 80K, right? We've all become reasonable rationalists in this bull market. So I'll bring this chart up to you, and this was the original chart, and we can see, I map out the bulls to bear cycles, right? So if we really zoom in, and I'm just going to scroll in here. If we zoom in, right, we saw a 5,000,000% in its kind of first run up. Then we saw a 94% dip in Bitcoin. We then saw it run up, and this, guys, is the monthly candles chart. We saw a 63,000% increase. We saw an 87% dip. Then from there, it ran up into a 12,000% increase in Bitcoin. You'll famously remember the 2018 run-up, 2017, 2018. And then a drop of 84%. And then going up to 2,162%. And we've had a retracement back down to the 15K mark of about 77%. So that is the dynamics of where we've come from. And you can see here, I've put it all up on screen, but there has been diminishing returns. If we really think about it, Bitcoin's going to have diminishing returns cycle by cycle, but the volatility also reduces. So when you're in that bear market, we're probably going to see, I don't know, maybe a 70% drop off in the bear market, the following bear market to the next bull. So how do I analyze this? You know, me and my brain, it kind of ticks a bit strangely. I want to know numbers. I want to get straight into it. So I was working out, okay, from 5,000,000% down to 63%, how much less of an increase has it been in that successive bull run? So how much less percentage-wise returns could you have in the next bull run? So minus 98.74% less increase in successive bull run from the 63,000 to the 12,100%, minus 80%, and then 12,100% down to 2,163% was a minus 82% less increase in the successive bull run. It's been around about the 80% mark. And if we follow that fictional moon math, my prediction would be an 82K Bitcoin, right? Because if you take the 80% less increase this bull run, you would be going down from 2,163% down to 432%. If it's 75%, we're probably looking around about a 540% increase this bull run for Bitcoin, which would bring it up to 98K. My personal opinion is this. Most people just hawkeye the price of any crypto asset during the bear market. They're so on it. You know, every hour, every day, every minute. They're watching, they're trying to find the bottom, they're trying to find the bottom. Or they just like to hurt themselves, really. They like to be a bit of a masochist and just see the pain in their eyes as they see their investments drop and drop and drop. However, no one really hawkeyes or snipes in on price targets when it comes to the bull market. Everything's euphoric. People are just really in that mindset of FOMO. They're living in the emotional high, right? They're smoking the emotional high. And so for us, the worry, I guess, I think once you get past that 75K mark towards that 80K mark for Bitcoin, you want to be right on the trigger, right? You want to be keeping a close eye. If you're wanting to take significant profits in this bull run, you need to be hawkeye in the price. Anywhere above the 75K mark, up towards the 80K mark. Now, my personal strategy is this. Maybe I pull out 50% of my bag and let the rest run. That is one way of doing it. It all depends really on your general situation. And Funding Jim had a really good comment when he was talking to a guy on the Twitter space last night. He was saying that it really is dependent on what your average entry price is. If your average entry price is down low and you've been buying in this bear market, it doesn't really matter because you're already in profit probably. And if we look at my hex bags, for example, I'm already in profit. I can give my crypto the best possible run it can. The problem with most crypto heads is that they look at tops and bottoms. That is the major issue within this game we play, if you want to call it a game. They're not really thinking about what their average entry price is. They're not looking at where the bottom is and being as close to the bottom as possible. And we're seeing this with the Pulsechain side of things, right? Pulsechain is going to be a first cycle coin, first cycle layer one coin. And so everyone's so focused intrinsically on, I need to earn this amount, this many X's for my gains. If we look at ETH, for example, and I'll bring this up on screen, ETH has done very, very well, right? And its first cycle really pumped up. You can see here the bottom, right at the bottom here. And this is kind of, you know, launched after the ETH Classic debacle. And we saw like very, very significant gains. And then there was the 95% drop off. And then we had another 5,786. But a lot of you guys, right, when you got into Pulsechain, let's just get a little paintbrush up here. We got into Pulsechain. If this was the Pulsechain chart based on off of the month-to-month candles, you're debating about buying here or buying down here or buying around here or here. You're not really thinking about, you're not really zooming out and thinking, hey, this is a longer-term play, right? So a lot of people are focused in and locked in on, hey, man, I've bought too high up here. I've not bought enough down here or even by this all-time low here. We look at things and we're so worried about what's going on in the first run and catching the first run that we forget the second run, maybe the third run as well. If we go back to the Bitcoin charts, yes, there was diminishing returns each cycle, but that worry only happens if you're buying at the tops. You're worried because your returns from here to here isn't that much. You're not thinking about, did I buy in this dip here? Did I buy in this dip here? Did I buy when it first launched here? Did I buy near the bottom here when it was starting to run up? These are all opportunities. These are all moments in time that can radically change the course of your life. Have a look at the ETH chart here. This is where we are in terms of Pulsechain. This, and these are the monthly 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So literally 6 months in, exactly the same as Pulsechain. We're in this zone here. I mean, we have so much more of a run-up to go. We have a bear market to come back. If you're buying in this zone here, you're buying in the best possible time. Do you think the ETH whale worries about the price when it's up here? When it's at 2K? When he was buying down here? Do you think the Genesis whale, the God whale, was worried around this mark when ETH's up here, when ETH was up here as well? These are like silly narratives that we play in our minds because we want to be top trader. Our ego gets in the way and we think that we're a top trader, we're going to be the best possible trader in the world. Most people have the Forex mindset when it comes to crypto, right? They want to be top trader. They want to be kingpin. Their egos get in the way. Do I need to exit my full position? Maybe not. Maybe I can take 50% out. Maybe I can take 30% out. Maybe I can take 75% and leave 25% to run. I had a good friend, Famous. He was talking about Bitcoin's never actually had a bear market. If you look on a 10-year chart, Bitcoin has never, ever, ever had a bear market. And he's got a real good point, because his time frame's a little bit higher than most. A lot of the younger guys within crypto don't worry as much as the older guys. I've noticed this. This is a common trend. It's a psychological trend. The reason why there's not much of a worry is because we do have a bit of time on our hands. As long as we live a healthy life and avoid accidents and injury, we don't really worry, because we look at future projections. We look on a long-term basis and we think, does it have a cult-like following? Is it needed? Will there be more stuff built on it? Will it be a more robust blockchain in the next bull run? You are your own worst enemy. Your emotions get in the way. And actually, on the longer term basis, you'll be fine. And so for a lot of people bought into the narrative. Unfortunately, they bought into the narrative sometimes at the top, which isn't always the best way to do things. However, you do have another opportunity. You've got value that you don't intrinsically see now. And for a lot of you, you'd be like, why would you say that? That's the worst possible thing to say. But these cryptos don't go to zero. Like, if you get into a pump and dump scam, sure. However, when there's community, when there's a cult-like following, when it's been around for 4 years, when it's got a brand new layer one, when there is demand for the product, long-term it's going to succeed. When Bitcoin first started, a lot of people just thought it was an absolute cult. A lot of people thought they were a bunch of weirdos. A lot of people laughed at the idea that there was money on the internet. And look what the big financial institutions are doing now. They realized late that they need to get in. So don't just chuck your pulse chain away. Don't chuck your assets away. Think also on a long-term basis, have a moon bag as well. Some of you might want to just cash everything out. Hey, that's up to you. I know I'm going to cash out a significant amount, and I'm probably going to buy the 90% retracement when Pulse does that in the bear market, because most layer ones do a 90% retracement in the next bear. Hope you liked the video. Please like, share, and subscribe. Also join the Telegram group. I'll put it on screen. Until next time.